Hello, it's Kat, and in today's tutorial, I'll introduce you to the Shapebuilder tool and show you how to make this fluffy cloud shape and this crescent moon. I've included a link to this file in the description down below if you'd like to follow along. The first thing we'll go over with the Shapebuilder tool is how to add shapes together. For that, I'm going to start drawing some circles for the top of a cloud, making sure that my fill color is set to white and my outline color is set to none. I'm holding down Shift as I make these circles so that they stay symmetrical and don't turn into stretched out ovals. And we'll just do a couple of different sizes here to get some variation for the top of the cloud. And now for the bottom of the cloud, I usually like to use my rectangle tool and just pull that out so that you have a solid base at the bottom. Now we have our cloud shape ready. I'm going to zoom in just a bit here. And before we use our Shapebuilder tool, you'll want to select all of the shapes that you want to combine. So with those selected, you can grab your Shapebuilder tool from the toolbar here, or you can hit Shift M on your keyboard to get that tool. Once you click the tool, you'll see this plus sign appear on your mouse. The default for the Shapebuilder is to combine shapes, and it functions pretty much the same as your Unite tool and your Pathfinder. So now I've just clicked and I'm dragging through all of the shapes that I want to combine without letting go. And that looks like we have them all. When I let go, you'll see that now we have your cloud shape. And if we look in our layers palette here on the cloud layer where I was drawing, you'll see it's just one path. So that's perfect. Now I can zoom out and I'm going to grab my cloud, hit I to get my eyedropper and apply this gradient. So that's how we make clouds. And now I will show you how to subtract shapes from each other to get this crescent moon shape. Subtracting shapes with the Shapebuilder tool is also very easy. We'll go ahead and start making our moon shape by drawing out another perfect circle holding Shift. I'm going to copy this with Control C or Command C on a Mac and paste it in place on top of the same circle using Control F or Command F on a Mac. I now have two copies of this circle perfectly on top of each other. So what we want to do now is scale from one corner so that you start seeing that if we subtract the smaller circle, we'll get this crescent shape on the outside. I'm going to scale this back up just a little bit. You can adjust this however you like to get the right kind of crescent for your design. And now we will select both of these like we did when we were adding. And once again, grab our Shapebuilder tool. Now I want you to hold Alt on a PC or Option on a Mac, and you'll see that the plus sign changes to a minus sign. Now we're ready to start subtracting these shapes so that we have just our crescent shape left. Once again, you can click and drag through the shapes that you want to subtract. And now I will just go ahead and adjust this moon. And now we've got our crescent moon shape. The only thing I did on the sample shape here was also to apply this gradient. And then I went in and made it a radial gradient and flipped it around. And of course, those are just design choices you can make for your own design. But that's just a quick example of how you can use the add and subtract features in your Shapebuilder tool to make a quick sky scene or anything else you want. The Shapebuilder tool is super convenient and can be a little less confusing than using the Pathfinder panel for beginners. I hope that was helpful. If it was, don't forget to leave a like and click here to check out more quick tips in Illustrator.